YouTube, what's up, kinfolk? How's it going? It's Casey Piper here. Sorry, my camera's a little messed up, just position-wise. Today, the 22nd of June, I went to the 2013 Greater Kansas City Pipe Club Pipe Show. Their annual show was yesterday, today, and tomorrow, and it was phenomenon. In the slam bomb. I don't know. Don't ask me. Great. Drillions of pipes. Drillions of backies. Drillions of people. Drillions of samples. I can't say enough. Oh, crap. I just spit on the lens right there. I'm not even going to touch it. I'm not going to deal with it. This is like the fourth take. I'm not going to stop. I got great stuff. I got a new pipe. I got some tobaccos. I got some samples. Plus, the other day, I got a box in from Big Star Cigar. I'm going to show you what I got. Plus, I got another tobacco. I'm on, like you guys, backy acquisition disorder. It's in full-fledged right now. Oh, my bank account is dying. Arms for the pole. Arms for the pole. It's hilarious. I got more tobacco in my house than I do food. If only we could nourish our bodies on tobaccos. Quite contrary. We cannot. I digress. As bread is to the body, so is squadron leader to the pipe smoker. And I just about said pipes and cigars. Which I've got to talk about because there's great things coming from them. I talked to the people at pipesandcigars.com. Good news. Nonetheless, Squadron Leader, it's in full effect. I got myself a tin. Finally, I haven't tried it yet. Super excited. Why is me talking to the Pipes and Cigars people so exciting, you ask? Doug, tell us, why is it so exciting? Because, my friends, Mississippi River's back. That's right, Mississippi. In his house. It's been on back order for like 80 gadrillion years. Those days are over, kids, because they bought out the freaking company who was making it, and they're making it on their own now. This is coming from the big guns of PNC.com. Big Guns himself said, we bought the company, we're blending it ourselves now. Back ordering is a thing of the past. So Plum Pudding, Mississippi River, it's in full effect. They got another company or blend that they've got going on. I don't know if it's their own, but they're going to be bringing in a new line, whether it's their own or somebody else's. I, as retarded as this is going to sound, forgot the name, and the writing on the package just says Smoker Saratoga. The name of the blend is Saratoga. I forget. It's some cool name. It's a cool name. Smoker's something. I forget. When I was in there, it smelled phenomenal. But now that I got home, it's topped with amaretto. Which I'm not, you know, no surprise here. I've said it before. I'm not an aromatics guy. Some people love them. I don't like them. I love the... Okay. Again, I'll say it for the last time, I promise. I love the smell of them. There's never been an aromatic that I've smoked where I haven't been like, this is disgusting. I love the smell of all of them. It's the flavor that kills me. There's only two aromatics that I've tried that have been decent. One of them is Island Rise 3-Star Blue. Phenomenal. It's, can't say enough about it. The other one I just got from Big Star Cigar, Cherry Bean. It's, you know, it's not bad. I've had worse, so it doesn't move me, but whatever. A couple more samples. Hearth and Home from the Pipe Show. Hearth and Home, Virginia Spice. Smells great. Smells a little Latakia heavy. Real similar. What else could I assimilate it to? Well, there's nothing I can assimilate it to right off the top of my head. And then, what did I just show you? Yeah, Virginia Spice. Larry's Blend. Little English in there, too. This stuff feels dry as a bone. She's ready to smoke right now. Smells like a good blend. a little lacking on the Perique end for me. I'm kind of a heavy Perique guy because it smells like a campfire to me, you guys. That's what I, when I smell Perique, I smell campfire. Think of it. Next time you smell a Perique, you know, blended tobacco, something that's got Perique in it, think campfire and then smell it. You'll be like, wow, it smells like a freaking campfire. So that was cool. A couple of tobaccos I'd never heard of, or a company that I'd never heard of, Brebbia. I'm just excited about both of these. I can't say enough. I'm really excited about this guy. Boy, I'm just excited about it. This one, I am excited about it because it's going to be a really cool adventure to smoke, but it's going to be an adventure nonetheless because this stuff smells like mayonnaise slathered all over week-old wet socks that I wiped my rear with. I know that's way too much information, but I'm just being straight with you guys. This stuff will make you puke if you smell it too long, but there's something behind it. There's something behind all the stink that makes me go, this is going to be a phenomenal freaking smoke. So, I got those. Pumped about that. I don't think... Did I show you this? Okay, if I showed you this already, please forgive me. Punch me through the screen. Punch me. I dare you. Yeah, that's what I thought. Savinelli Roma. I'm just excited about this as well. It's got a wide open draw. I'm going through an Paul phase right now. Oh, I'm just excited. It is an estate. The guy who got it cleaned out the stem and the shank, if I'm correct, really well, but left all the cake in it, which was kind of weird. I'm like, at least take some of the cake out. It was thick with cake. So I came home, whipped out my Dremel, cleaned out most of the cake except for a real thin layer. You know, it's just burnt up tobacco. I'm not fazed by it. And, you know, if there's ever anything in there, it's going to be dead because bacteria doesn't survive in that stuff. So,
at least from what I know, from what I understand.
So, it's just a beautiful pipe. It's got a great little gold band here. I don't know if you can see that crap. Yeah, like right there, it's got a gold band. And then the stem is beautiful. I love how just deeply bent it is. All the way around. It's almost an Paul, you know, minus the apple look that it's got going on. So, just super excited about it. It's going to be a great smoke. I'm anticipating great things from it. The other thing I got, I don't know if I said this already, but I did. I ordered Cherry Bean and Delta Mojo from Big Star Cigar. I recorded a box opening, but then when I went back and watched it, I realized I went through a little bit of a phase where I was being an aromatics hater, and I need to go through Aromatics Haters Anonymous because, you know, each his own. You know, who am I to be retarded? And, you know, what if? If you like it, smoke it. Let's see. This is from my own Cigar and Tobacco Limited. This is my tobacco shop here in KC. If you guys ever get out to the Kansas City area, if you don't check out Cigar and Tobacco Limited, you are missing out. Hundreds of pipes, I kid you not. Hundreds of pipes, both estate and brand new. They got tons of each. They've got lots of different bulk tobaccos. Probably 25, 30. Different blends, all kinds of stuff, just great stuff. Plus tons of everything you could ever dream of for the most part. Just great stuff going on there. So, oh my gosh, I'm tired. It's my bedtime, guys. I work nights at a house of prayer here in Kansas City. So, oh, I think that's it. So I'm going to show you some live footage really quick, mostly for Duke Avin, if that's how I pronounce it, Duke. He asked me for some footage of the show. Here it comes, and then I'm out. Deuces.